Hi friends, today we will discuss about file connector concepts. So here we can see this is the file connector. We have multiple components related to this file connector: copy, create directory, delete, list, move, read, rename, write. So using this file connector we can implement as an inbound endpoint and outbound endpoint as well. So we can read files at certain periods of time and delete and move and leave the files as it process. So append the output to existing files and copy files from one directory to another directory. So we can read input files and save input files to backup. So create new files with specific names. So here what we are doing is, here I have the list component from the file. So here what I am doing is, based on the pattern, I am list out the all the files from a given directory. So this is the pattern I have given, order underscore star. So here is the configuration for this. See, here we have the file configuration. And here I gave the pattern, file name pattern. So order underscore star, it read all the files which contains order underscore. So this application is already running. So I will show the file names. So this is the list, it contains 6 files. So in the typed attributes, so here we can see the file name, file directory. See, this is the path and file name. This is the file name and the type and the size and time, everything we can see here. Say, even size also we can see. So actually I didn't place any data inside the file, so it showing 0. So like this way we can see other files as well. So this is order 123445. So for other we can see the different file name. See, 123445567. So like this way we can check the given directory is empty or not, what is the size of the files, and we can check. If you want, we can filter out the file names. See, order, see, I have given QWERTY, QWERTY, file name I have given like this. Orders, order underscore star I have given. So it is reading both integer and string type after underscore. So like this way we can differentiate, we can give the pattern, and we can list out the files. So now what I will do is, I will give another pattern to read the files. So what I will give is order underscore and sales underscore star I will give. So this time we can see both the order underscore files and sales with the file name starts with sales, not underscore. I have saved the files with sales hyphen. So save it. see the parser. The debugger pointer is here. So let me move to next point, list. So now we have 9. Earlier we see 6 files only. Now we can see both the files. See here, order related file and sales related file. See this sales. I gave sales hyphen. So this is the regex we have to use. Order underscore star and sales hyphen star. So it return me the files which starts with order underscore and sales hyphen. So like this way we can filter out the files from the list, and we can check the size as well and the time, everything. See here we have all the details, attributes and the last access time, creation time and the size and regular file directory. Then we have path is there and the file name and media type. So these all are useful. So file name is mostly we can for filtering the files. So we'll use this, and the remaining time and everything, these things also useful to filter out based on time. So we can use these fields as well, creation date and all. So next what we are doing is based on the list size, we are checking the size and we are reading the each file and writing into the specific location. So and while writing into the specific directory, we are zipping the files. So to zip all the files are file by file, each file. We'll see in next video. So subscribe to my channel, and if you have any questions, paste it in the comments box so that I can reply. So thank you.